Okay, all of you are requested, please switch off your audio. Please switch off your audio or mute your audio as well as video. It is making noise. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So I will start within 2 minutes. How many attendees are there right now? Because
25, sir.
only. Okay, we will wait for some time. And from next week onward, I think your data analytic lecture will also be there from next week onward. So there will be 4 lectures in next week. And the schedule will be circulated in your WhatsApp group, I think tomorrow or day after tomorrow. For next week schedule. And number of lectures will be as per your syllabus only from next week onward. Please join fast. So we'll take the recap of the yesterday's lecture without wasting our time also. And it is requested to all students, those who have not joined it, respective HPC batches, please join today at least. Then only your attendance get reflected in attendance spreadsheet. Okay, because still many students having the zero attendance out of four, and sorry, out of five, because yesterday it was the fifth lecture and today is the sixth lecture, and attendance sheet or Google sheet is already circulated for fifth lecture yesterday along with the video link also. So whether you have submitted, if you are not submitting Google Sheet for attendance, then your attendance will not reflect in you can say the attendance spreadsheet. And if you are submitting that same sheet 100 times, then only your attendance will be marked only once. Remember this one. So don't waste your time there, because as per my observation, students are submitting that 2 times, 3 times. Few students are there, not all students, and I cannot tell their names also right now, because every day I observe your can say the how many times you have submitted your Google Sheet there. Okay, how many attendees are there right now? Saurabh is there today? Hello. Am I audible? 36. Okay, it is. We'll not wait for because. So in last lecture, we already discussed about the communication model of parallel platforms, right? Na, under. Yeah, shared address space, that is the NUMA and UMA. That is also discussed. So these two models we have discussed yesterday, UMA, Uniform Memory Access Model, and NUMA, Non-Uniform Memory Access Model or Multi-Computer System. That is also discussed yesterday. So if you see there, in case of the UMA, there is no restriction to processor to access the memory element or you can say the block. But in case of the NUMA, there are some certain restrictions, because some processor may get the delayed content from the specific memory block or memory element, if you say there, because each processor having the individual memory as well as cache in case of the NUMA model. So they can try to access the memory element of other processor also, if you see there, using the interconnection network there. That's why you can say the data access is not uniform in case of the NUMA model, but in case of the UMA model, it is the uniform memory access. Well, just taking the recap, because students are joining within, when we have discussed about the differences between NUMA and UMA, shared address space platforms or the multi-computer systems. Then we have discussed about the shared address space versus shared memory machines also yesterday. Then discussed about the MPI. Then we have started, this is also discussed, message passing versus shared address space platform. Then we have started the physical organization of parallel platforms yesterday. So under physical organization of parallel platform, we already discussed about the architecture of an ideal parallel computer. And depending on the, you can say the access permissions, data access permissions from memory, these models further classified into four different subclasses, like the EREW PROM model or machine, CREW PROM model, ERCW PROM or CRCW PROM. That is discussed yesterday, I think. Okay. In architecture of an ideal parallel computer. And their classification, that is the architecture of an ideal parallel computer, how you can classify into four different subclasses. PROM stands for parallel random access machines, okay, not memory here, meaning. So exclusive read, exclusive write, EREW, concurrent read, exclusive write, CREW. Then similarly, exclusive read, concurrent write, ERCW PROM machine or model, concurrent read, concurrent write, CRCW PROM model. That is discussed yesterday. So we'll move on next topic from the same subtopic from the same topic, that is the physical organization of parallel platforms. From this, we have discussed the architecture of an ideal parallel computer. Then we'll discuss about the, you can say the, this is already discussed, ideal parallel computer, and how, what does concurrent write means, common, arbitrary, priority, and some. This depends on the type of data you are writing at specific memory location, and depending on the permissions available to the processing elements. Then physical complexity of an ideal parallel computer, how you can compute, that is also discussed in terms of the asymptotic notation, big O of 1. Then today we'll start the subtopic, sorry. This one. That is the interconnection networks for parallel computers. So depending on the, so here nodes means processing elements or the processors or the machines, if you see there. and that much is you have the processing element, if you see that. So connection between two nodes or the processor might be on a point to point basis, that is also called as the static network. Okay, or two nodes can be connected through the intermediate hop or the switch. Okay, or you can say the router or whatever. So that kind of connection is called as the switching network or the dynamic interconnection network, if you see that. So in this subtopic, that is the interconnection network for parallel computers, we'll see static as well as the dynamic network with their types and examples, if you see that. And later on we'll see the network cost of the respective examples. Then in case of the static, or we can see this current slide, interconnection networks carry data between processors and to memory. Yes, you know. Then interconnection can be made using the switching elements and the links or the wires, if you see there. So wires might be different wires you have studied already in C and computer networks, like the fiber optics, coaxial cables, or the twisted pair cables, whatever. So interconnects are classified as static network or the dynamic network again. So point to point communication links among processing nodes are referred to as a direct networks or the static network. Remember this one. And the connection between two nodes or two or more nodes using the switching elements, okay, it is also called as the dynamic network or the indirect networks, if you say. So how many students joined till now?
55, sir.
55, okay. No problem. Then I will show you diagram so that you will understand in a better way what is static network and what is the dynamic network. So two diagrams are shown in current slide. A showing the static network and B showing the dynamic network. If you see there, so dotted line circle indicates the region or the area of that particular network. If you see there in diagram A, if you see there, total four processing elements or the nodes are there. Okay, and they are connected to one another on peer to peer, you can say the fashion, that is the one element is connected to other on peer to peer basis, and they are connected over network using the network interface or using the particular switch which connect the two elements there. But this is not a standard switching elements there, if you see there, because it can connect only the maximum two nodes. That kind of network interface is used in case of the static network. Okay, so two nodes can communicate on peer to peer basis, if you see there. So it is called as the direct communication, or it is called as the direct network, or it is also called as the static network, if you see there. And generally communication pattern is fixed in case of the static network, whereas in case of the indirect network or the dynamic network, communication pattern is not fixed because the data rate and whatever, it may change because the data will be passed through the switches or the switching elements, if you see that. Okay, so if you see diagram B, that is showing the dynamic network, or it is also called as the indirect network, because the communication between two nodes are not direct, or these nodes are not connected directly like the peer-to-peer you can say connection in case of the static network. So connection will be established between, sorry, through intermediate switching elements or the switches. So switching elements you already studied, like the switches, routers, hubs, likewise. So you need to establish the communication link between that is your processing node and the destination processing node in order to send or receive the data. Okay, then you can start transmitting packets of the data or messages, if you see there. So this is the difference between the static and dynamic interconnection network. So examples of static network, then again the you can say the tree-based network is there, bus-based network is there, okay, mesh is there, okay, or mesh-based networks are there. And in case of the indirect or dynamic network, you can see the multi-stage, you can see the connection or network, if you see that. That kind of networks are there. So we'll see their examples in detail in incoming topic, that is the network topology, where you will understand the whether that particular topology is the part of the static network or the dynamic network. So if you have any query, then you can ask in last 10 minutes. Okay, one request is there, Saurav, if recording stops automatically or by mistake, so please try to start from your end. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. If it does not stop, then no need to start recording. Okay, same recording.
Sure, sir.
Okay. Okay, good. So this is all about the static and dynamic interconnection network. So question on this topic might be, that is the what is static network and what is dynamic network, or explain the static and dynamic network with suitable diagram or example. So such type of question might be there in NCERT examination or NCERT examination for 4 to 5 marks again. So somebody has unmuted their mic, I think. Please mute their audio. Somebody has unmuted their audio. Please mute that audio because it is making noise. So this is all about the static and dynamic interconnection networks just discussed. Then moving towards the next slide, that is the what is the degree of switch and whatever. These concepts are given here regarding the network components. So switches map a fixed number of inputs to outputs, if you see there. In case of the, you can say the indirect network or the dynamic network just discussed. And the total number of ports on a switch is the degree of the switch. It indicates the number of inputs that switch can have, or and number of outputs it can, you can say the output links it will have. The cost of a switch grows as the square of the degree of the switch. The peripheral hardware linearly as the degree. Yes, that is the cost of switching element will goes on increasing. Okay, please mute your audio. Somebody has kept their audio on. Please mute your audio. It is making that is a big noise. Okay, Saurabh, can you check who have kept their audio on?
It's not showing anybody, sir.
Okay. Then, okay. It is requested to all students, please take care while joining. Please keep your audio that is in off state or in muted state, please, because it is creating huge noise there. Okay, so cost of switch goes on increasing as per the degree of the switch, because it require the number of ports that will be increased as per its degree. Degree means input degree and output degree you might have studied. That is the number of input it can accept and number of output it can.